happen.
Tonight, word that kids and adults overdosing on bath salts are not just putting their own lives at risk, they're now also threatening police. Evening, I'm Jack Atherton. Cherie's got the night off. News 5's Stephanie Stone just back from Goshen. She has the story. Steph?
Jack, problem is the drug is so new that paramedics don't have a way to combat the effects. And to make matters worse, those who take it become extremely violent.
They need to go to these places and get them off the street.
Andrew Shuckman knows more than he ever needed or wanted to know about bath salts. It all started on his son's 27th birthday. That's when Andrew found him laying in the yard.
That's him right there. His eyes had all rolled back. He didn't know. He thought everybody was out to get him, poisoning. He wouldn't stand still. He was just screaming and hollering. That stuff is nuts.
Andrew's son is one of a handful of cases in Goshen Township in the past few weeks. It was doctors at the hospital who told the Shuckmans their son had overdosed from the fertilizer-based salts that you can buy most anywhere. When they got home, they found evidence of the cheap high in their garage.
So there was little jars. That's what they get it in when they get it at the stores.
It's not illegal yet, which means police can't really treat it like other drugs, and paramedics can't either.
We don't know how to treat them. We don't really know what's going on with them. We have to assume. It's a guessing game.
Which means all they can do is keep the victims calm and rush them to the hospital, something Andrew Shuckman is all too familiar with.
See, what can law enforcement do? I mean, they can't really do anything. And that's the scary part.
Governor Kasich recently signed a bill banning bath salts and other drugs like it into law. It won't take effect, though, until October. The salts have also been banned in Kentucky and Indiana. Jack?